doing this crap.
Yeah. I can't. I told you.
Thanks. Thanks for being a trooper.
All right, y'all. You know what it is. Thursday. Try to get y'all a little hype before we came up in here. It's a beautiful day. Beautiful day. I got somebody bleeding green over here rocking purple and gold. But you know what it is. Thursday, 6:30-ish. Got the gang with me, starting five in the building. Corsair Radio. We at the Good News Radio Station. And I'm going to kick it right to my boy, the point guard, Mike Kell.
Hey, yes, sir. It is Mike Kell, the PG in the building. You know the Magic Johnson of the thing. Make sure this thing is going live and going the way it needs to be. And it is showtime, baby. Showtime, just like the Lakers back in the day. So, man, the PG here, got to lead the way. Got my boy Himes, Mr. Purple and Gold today. Bro got on a thong. Almost a thong. So he's kind of sad right now, so we'll let him introduce himself last, as he is the loser of today. What's up, Mike?
So I'm going to just go ahead and let you know this. Ida Pappy, Big Mike in the building from the wood, came through. So it's going to be a live one today.
And, clearly.
And Alex, we still love you, big dog. But,
did anybody bring singles? Because Lil Mama in here twerking.
I got some not. Singles.
I might try to hit him with the Nelly, though, with the credit card.
If you got singles on you, I straight up will dance. I don't give a shit.
We will stall on that.
Yeah.
Camera lady might want
something. We ain't ready for that one.
Nah, Jackie ain't getting the lap dance from this.
Oh.
She ain't wanting none of this Wonder Bread.
Jackie, beware, because you might get that lap dance.
But I do. I do.
I've been having gas today, so if I do give you a lap
dance, I'm
hey, so Himes World is in the building, as you could tell, with the nonsense. What's up, Himes?
How's it going, guys? Shout out to everyone in the Celtics Nation group who's watching live right now on FB. I know it's a rough day. It's
faith.
Okay, so I want you guys to know, before anything else, my mom sent me a text message after the game last night and was like, that game was absolutely terrible. Like, it was so funny because my mom was trying to be super laid back about it, and I'm over here just like ranting on IG Live. Like, at one point, there was 1,000 people looking in on one video where I'm literally slamming the table, having to have a drink. I'm so pissed off. What's up, guys? This is Himes World. Shalom, shalom.
And hey, a Lakers jersey. You shouldn't have been mad. We gave you the outcome at the... We gave you the outcome.
I tried to tell you.
This is coming from the same dude that said the Lakers were going to make the playoffs.
First of all, man, I believe the Lakers make
the
playoffs.
Me and the whole world.
I'm not putting shade on you. I'm not putting shade on you. I'm putting shade on him. Because he's trying to claim that he said, and they think this was going to happen from the get-go. Bro, you didn't know
it
kind of
was, bro. Nah.
I did.
We said this, I think, mid-March or early March when they started having like this like weird run. He was like, these dudes is just not good.
Facts, bro.
They just looked bad. It was like they're not gonna make it.
Put that Celtic group.
They were okay,
me.
But they weren't gonna make
yeah,
it.
I'm about to say,
okay, I'm already getting crap from Celtics fans. All right, look, I am a Celtics fan. I'm diehard.
Show the socks.
I lost a bet where if the Celtics went out, I had to show up to the station wearing a Speedo and a Laker jersey.
Hey, you will be seeing pictures and video up on IG and Facebook.
He's a Celtic. Faithful, you understand me?
Yes.
He's a Celtic faithful. We will attest to that. He has the socks to prove it. I'm not just saying because he has them on now. I didn't know it was gonna happen. I appreciate it because that's how loyal he is.
No, I knew it was gonna happen.
But I knew you guys were gonna lose. I'm sorry.
Hey, I told him in the summer that his team wouldn't make it to the conference finals. But man, let's get right to the playoffs. So we might as well start there. Second round in NBA playoffs coming to an end. And we can start with that series. The Bucks won. Gentlemen sweep 4-1. The Celtics, man, they were just out of whack. So from game one on down, they shot 54% game one, 40% game two, 43% game three, 38% game four. Game five, they only shot 28%. Kyrie Irving the big time star. He played like a guy ready for the season to end. He scored 102 points on 104 shots, which is not good
you
at all.
You were with me last night when we
that's
saw that.
That's called abysmal.
That's me knowing my work, bro. Don't try to hate me like that.
Bro, we were literally together. I showed it to you like 102 points on 104 shots. And I looked at you and I'm like, yep, I'm ready for Terry Rozier to be the starting point guard.
Hey,
he's going to have to be.
It was tough, but you just didn't get a lot from Jason Tatum. He showed up for probably one game of the series. So it was just a lot of the Celtics not showing up and performing the way that they needed to. So, hey, Milwaukee, the best team in the league in the season, looked like the best team in the league in this series. What's up, Mike?
I was going to say they look like he had a he had a good game cumulative throughout the series. What you mean?
Hey, facts. If you add up his stats, bro, those were one good game.
Do you understand when he had single digits? I said, this is Jason Tatum, Mister. I led the Celtics in the playoffs. I am the man. Next season, I got it.
Hey, he is, yeah, bro. He is Alex's Tatum, boyfriend.
Couldn't do it.
He's Alex's boyfriend. Alex was talking about him this whole offseason. Jason Tatum, he's worked out with Kobe. He worked out with Kobe. God damn it, he's not Kobe.
He's going to get better. His mentality has changed.
He had the worst parts of Kobe in him this season.
Facts.
He was pulling up. They just was not going in, bro.
I got it. I figured it out, Alex. He worked out with Kobe. You're right. He's the old Kobe Bryant. That's who he played like.
Yeah, Kobe when he was last season. Last season.
Yeah, other than the 6-point game.
He's post-Achilles Kobe.
Wow. Y'all cold. Hey, Tatum, you will be good one day, bro.
That was good.
Let me tell you guys.
That was a good one. I like that one.
Hey, we got Pocket Burrito in the building and Kenny from Touchdown with Tangents. They're up next. But we just feel the Lakers aren't winning right now. We're hurt. We're going to talk about that later. But it feels so good when your arch rival gets their ass kicked. They're embarrassed by Giannis. And you know that possibly that their best player will be out of there. It's like, if we're going to suck, Celtics need to suck too. And it looks like it's going to happen. So... I'm so excited, man. What do you guys feel about Milwaukee? You guys really – to me, if KD isn't healthy, I think that they're going to win a championship.
I didn't think Giannis would be able – I thought he would freeze under the pressure at some point, and it looks like he's only getting stronger as the playoffs continue. And he's unstoppable.
Man.
Like, he can't shoot. He shoots, but he can't. And he's averaging, what, like 30 and like 15 or something, or close to it?
12 and 5 assists for the series.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
Nah, like just watching him play is probably the best part of the playoffs. If you can ever catch a game and just watch him just dominate. Like, it's just like, I don't know what else. Like, any team can do with them, especially Brogdon's back.
Yep.
He actually looked like, he didn't miss a beat. He had about 15 yesterday. I know they were probably, like, some garbage time minutes, but that's what you need. Get your confidence up. Get a little more rhythm. Get a little wind in you, because you got to play game. You can't – there's no treadmill that's going to help you work out for the floor. So.
Yeah, so, hey, it's crazy. So, Justin Timberlake over there, can you cry as a river and tell us what happened to your Celtics, and what do you feel about Milwaukee, man?
I'm going to ignore that first comment.
Answer the question.
Answer the question.
Well, 99-cent store version of Earl Boykins. To tell you how it is, I went there with that.
It's okay.
So I'm going to give this rant. I got to take my watch off. Celtics fans. Yeah, okay. Anthony over here in the Celtics group. The Bucks beat us bad. All right. We got dicked down.
You sure did.
We got
you have
down.
The wrong outfit. You might want to choose your
words. Yeah, watch your words
wisely.
Nah, you looking like little mama today,
man.
Mama,
all right, let's get it right. All right,
she got to put on her.
So the Celtics got fucked. The media circus around Kyrie Irving this entire season did not help anybody. The mixture of trying to reincorporate Gordon Hayward, which you paid the guy $31 million, so you have to fucking play the guy. I don't care what you say. On top of Kyrie Irving coming back, ruining the chemistry that Rozier, Brown, and Tatum built last year in the playoff run.
This is our Celtics.
It didn't work out, and that's okay. But I will be the first fan, first and foremost, to tell you the same thing I told Mikel months ago. Kyrie Irving, it's been nice knowing you.
No team won the trade with Cleveland and Boston when we traded IT for Kyrie. At the end of the day, no team won. Because look at where both teams are at this point.
I agree.
So for me, at this point, look, I'm going to tell it like it is. The Celtics are actually sitting pretty pretty right now. And I said that double time for a reason. The Celtics are going to be fine. Because think about it. They have a lot of good young pieces already in the system. They can go after some free agents if they want to. But realistically, their best move actually is trimming some of the fat in-house. So letting Kyrie go, reforming their system to go back to what it was with Terry at the helm, getting younger, and then getting the fuck out of Gordon Hayward's contract where you have to trade him along with a washing
machine
and
Gordon.
10 first-round picks. I'm okay with that. So for me, I'm not worried. I'm actually relieved. I said this on IG Live yesterday. I'm actually relieved. I don't have to fucking hear about Kyrie Irving in a Celtics uniform anymore. Just get
Two more months.
Well, yeah,
until
but
he signs.
And then every time you play him four times
know.
A year when you play him New
no,
York.
No, but you know what I mean. It's inevitable that he's leaving. So, yeah. Like, realistically, it doesn't matter at this point. Like, I just, for me, I want it over with. I don't want him in a Celtic uniform because, let's be real, that press conference he gave at the ending was pretty evident that he didn't care. He didn't want to be. He didn't want to be. So, for me, look, the Celtics are going to be okay. We're going into next season looking better than the Lakers are right now. So let's make that clear. Shout out to all the Celtics.
Fuck you, me.
Hey, he's only one champion in the season, so we all the same.
The Clippers are looking better than the Lakers now going into next season.
Whatever.
Too.
Hey, so what do you feel about Milwaukee, guys? Like, I think that, they're going to be a tough out, man.
It is going to be coming out of the East. Are we asking? Wait. The question is, are we asking who's coming out of the East?
How do we feel about them coming out the East and – If you have them coming out the East, man, do you think they can really win the championship?
Man, I think for me, I don't know what you guys think, but I think it's a toss-up. I think that it could either go – I think it goes the distance, 6 or 7 with Toronto and Milwaukee, and I think the biggest matchup that makes a difference is we know that Giannis is going to get covered by Kawhi, and although – listen to me. Although that matchup seems good because we know how great Kawhi is defensively – watching him play against Giannis just really doesn't look like he can, like there isn't stopping Giannis, right? There's containing him to some degree and making him dish out to the open shooters on the wings and having guys like Siakam and having some of the hard-nosed defenders like Van Vliet, Ibaka surrounding Kawhi will help them. But that matchup is really going to be the matchup I think that dictates the series. So if Kawhi can somewhat cover him, they'll push it to 6-7 and they could potentially win. But look, Giannis makes everyone on that team better. Fucking Kalnaughton, Mirotic, Tony Snell at one point, all those guys. George Hill had a wide open dunk like he was in college again. The fact that the Celtics were able to let this man go straight down the lane, have a wide open dunk, he put them on a fucking poster.
He looked like
George
D-Rose.
Hill.
Oh,
yeah. He had a flashback moment.
Yeah, he
Dude,
looked like
D-Rose.
That shouldn't be happening.
That's what we said, but it's okay. Oh, but like I was saying, you got to understand that Milwaukee was bred to smack y'all for this one.
Yeah, they, during the season, they did the same thing, so...
I'm just trying to tell you. I said, I said, Milwaukee was bred to smack y'all for this one. I believed in you guys going 6, though. I'm the one that made the bet. I believed in y'all at least going 6.
Uh-oh.
Oh, the gentleman sweep did happen.
Hey, we got us a caller that's calling in
Good luck
right
next
now.
Season. 1, 2, 3, Cancun.
We're about to answer this. Yeah, they going fishing for real.
I can't wait to see that freaking slideshow on.
Hey, yo, it's Courtside Radio with the Starting Five. State your name.
Hey, what's up, bro? It's Phillip.
Oh, what's up, Phillip?
Big dog.
What's up, bro?
Hey, what's up, guys? Nothing much. I just wanted to call in and clown Alex one time.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone's going to be clowning me for the next, like, 3 weeks because of the Speedo Laker jersey.
Until next season, bro.
We love you, man. We love
you. Deserve it.
Yeah.
You deserve it.
Hey, so, hey, Phillip, what you feel about Milwaukee, man, going forward?
So I wanted them to win, but I thought the Celtics were going to get together and pull it out, man. But I'm really impressed with Milwaukee, man. But that boy Giannis, like I was saying, he's unstoppable, man. We haven't seen anything like this in a long time in the NBA, man. So the void was left when LeBron left the East, and Giannis stepped up to the challenge to say he wanted to fill that void, man. He's showing it, you know. He's showing it throughout these playoffs and throughout the regular season as well. And
right.
He seems in great condition. He doesn't seem like he's tiring down or anything, man. So,
yeah,
I'm with Giannis.
Hey, and they have an entire team that's built to play well together. And they built so perfectly with that guy because he's not shooting too many jumpers. It's all to the rim. And he just has shooter everywhere.
They built the formula perfect. Yep. They built the team perfectly.
Even the even the center, you know, Lopez is out there hitting threes, you know. So they literally have the whole team around him. Every position is a shooter, basically, around him and allowing him to get to the lane.
He had 8 assists.
Yeah, so if you, yeah, and that's crazy because if your center is pulling away the other team best big and shot blocker, that means he has no one there to stop him from scoring. So 30, 12, and 5 in the series is, man, very impressive, especially for a guy.
Domination.
Yeah, people weren't sure, like, is he that best player in the league? And he had to do it in the playoffs, and, man, he's done it so far.
Yeah, he's killing him.
Yeah, so, hey, Phillip, hey, call us back later, bro. We got more to talk about, man.
All right, sounds good.
Yeah, thanks for calling, man.
We love you, big dog. Appreciate you.
No problem.
Yeah, so.
I hate you.
Alex was talking about the matchup of Toronto and Milwaukee, but not so fast. As you know, before today's game, which they are playing now and it's live, last time I checked, Philly was up 78-61.
Already?
But, yeah.
Wait, what?
Yeah, Philly's up.
No,
I knew that was going seven. Shout out Chris Broussard. He didn't believe me. But
I ran into him in Vons yesterday.
Oh, for real?
In Inglewood.
Oh, you should. You said what's up to him?
Yeah, that's why I was like, hold up, bro. Like,
he lives in Inglewood, I told you.
I had little man on too.
Oh, you should have told him what's up, bro.
83-63.
Yeah. What? Hey, so before we got here for today's game, Ben Simmons so far had 33 points, 34 shot attempts. Embiid pretty much had one good game of the series, which was game, what was that, number three at home when he scored 35 points.
Yeah.
Kawhi is looking like a legit top three guy. It's no debate. He's back, maybe even better than he's ever been. But game five was a big fix for Toronto because they haven't been getting any scoring from anybody else other than Kawhi and Siakam. They were able to get 105 points. And Toronto's have been very impressive this year in the playoffs. Through eight of the ten games, they got under 100 points. Yeah, I'm stumbling. I'm excited because I picked Philly to make it to the conference finals.
There's no team I want to lose more than Philadelphia. I fucking hate Philly.
Yeah, I told him to put the drinks
down. Don't we got
down.
Wings bet on that?
I don't. No, you were drinking enough. You don't even remember.
We had wings. I said that if the Celtics weren't going to the finals, I said it was the Bucks. That was the bet I made. And you were like, it's either going to be Philly or Toronto, but it won't be Milwaukee.
Definitely going to be Milwaukee.
It could be. But
let me tell you something.
Yeah, let me hear it, Mike.
This is the theory I had going in. Whoever was going to win the Milwaukee series and out of the Golden State and Houston series is who the final is. Like,
so you're not going to give any – sorry. I didn't mean to.
No, you're good. Go ahead.
I was just going to say, you're not going to give – Charles Barkley any like type of attention for the bet with Portland making it to the NBA Finals?
No.
That's what I want to know.
They're not even going to be Denver's looking like right
Dame.
Now.
I love Dame, but it is.
I think Denver figured it out.
Yeah, I agree with that.
First of all, Jokic 3 straight triple doubles, which was.
Hey.
That threw me off.
It's crazy. Right? Hey, we're going to get to Jokic,
yeah,
bro.
Okay, we'll get
amazing.
There.
Hey, go ahead.
And we're I was going to saying that earlier this year. I was like, Jokic is that good? Like,
you know what?
Don't say nothing, because I say he was top five. Y'all wanted to laugh at me. So.
I said he was top five, too. Say that.
He wasn't here last week. That was Phillip.
I'm not in on that.
But, I'm not in on that at all. I told y'all about that.
So before today's game, Simmons and Embiid had combined for 20 points, 13 rebounds, and 13 turnovers in the last game. And you had Kawhi and Siakam, 46 points, 21 rebounds. But not so fast,
my
man.
Friend.
Today, Philly is smacking them. It is live right now. Oh, another call. People love us today, bro.
They thirsty today.
Man, they love us.
We love you. We love y'all.
Who you got there? Who is that?
Hey, Courtside Radio with the starting five, man. State your name.
Man, it's the key good news, man. I have to say. That just because somebody has a good season doesn't automatically put them in the top five.
Thank you, Keith.
Ding, 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 ding.
I really appreciate you coming on here.
He's top five of this season. Like when you
message.
Bro, it's only about what have you done for me lately.
No, it's not. Bro, no, it's not. What are you talking about? Because if that's the case, LeBron's out of the top five then.
Yeah, we agree on that.
No, we did not agree.
I told you he wasn't. I said he wasn't.
No, you and I are on the same page. LeBron is not top five.
He's not top five. I don't have LeBron top five player right now.
You said he was.
Wow.
Keith, no. Keith, you're always wrong. This is the only time you was right. I appreciate you.
I said he was. Like, I said he was.
Also the best point guard.
We all agree Mikel's not right ever.
Say that again, Keith.
I feel like you did have LeBron in your top five.
No, I had him. I had him out of my five. I can remember my five.
Give it to us. Go ahead.
I had Giannis, Harden, Steph, KD, and Kawhi.
Oh, you had Steph in there too?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's fair.
And then you got AD.
I mean, that's arguable though.
Yeah,
everything's arguable after like the top three.
Yeah,
you got to understand LeBron's down season is most of these players' best season they could have.
Facts.
Which is random,
but
like,
it got an equal winning. But it's about
bro.
What have you done for me lately? You know what I'm saying?
Kyrie didn't do anything.
Like you can say, wow. Hey, my girl is a supermodel, you know. But if you haven't seen your girl in 2 months, bro, that's not your girl. You know what I'm saying? So it's the same situation. You haven't
It's a long distance thing.
Nah, bro. I'll tell you.
She working abroad.
It don't work like that.
She working. She working something.
Look who's talking.
I love you, Aaron.
Wait, say it again, Keith. Working. Sorry. We
she
got
working.
No, it's cool.
There you go.
I
got that one twerking.
Man, you're a real one, bro.
Yeah.
I actually feel my balls going into my butt.
Hey, Alex is
a real one.
Hey, Keith.
Hey, make sure that you take a full picture in front of the separate piece.
No, hey.
Posting on the page.
Oh, my God. We got you.
Yeah, we got you. Hey, Keith, thanks for calling in. Call us back when we talk those nuggets so we can talk about Jokic, dog, so I can tell you why it's top five. All right, man. All right, later.
Man, we have to do a solo and a group shot on that one.
Yeah.
Bro, that's
that's
insane. That's going to be live, bro.
He's a trooper, man. But, yeah, Philly is up big, more than 15 points right now.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why my ESPN is tripping, but it is.
Yeah, my internet is not.
Yeah, but last time I checked, Ben Simmons was 7 for 10. He had 16 points. Embiid only had 9, but Ben Simmons came to play. I think if they play the way of let Kawhi get his, let Siakam get his, shut down everything else,
everybody,
you win.
That is the formula for every single game. If you look at every box score for every game, Kawhi 30, 40. Siakam 20-30, everybody else sucked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Kyle Lowry has like
get 11.
If you can keep Kyle Lowry and Danny Green out of it, you're pretty much good.
Oh my God!
And Marc Gasol can't play make.
Yeah,
because if they start running the offense through him, then you in trouble.
Yeah. Bro, he lost that ability, which is very random. I thought he would have like thrived in that part.
They weren't using him properly.
Not at all.
That and also
they're not using him right.
He's old now. Like we forget. Like look, Gasol's been playing well for years, right? Having him with Mike Conley, who he's played with basically for his entire career, basically extended it and didn't really show any flaws. But as soon as he gets to Toronto, wait, what?
It gave him a crutch.
Yeah, gave him a crutch. And look at him now in Toronto with Kyle Lowry. Like, it's not the same. You're not going to get the same thing. And Kyle isn't a pass-first point guard.
Yeah. And the last game in Game 5, the reason why Toronto looked so well, because Philly was dumb enough to say, let's double and get the ball out of his hands. So he's a smart player, a good player. He was just dishing the ball off, getting open shots for everyone else. Their confidence start going. They scored 105 points as a 105 points other than Siakam and Kawhi Leonard. You're going to lose that game.
Oh, you lost.
Yeah.
Hands down.
Yeah. So it's like today.
Same thing with the Bucks yesterday. That was pretty much what they did to the to the team.
So it's like today they decided to say, hey, let them get theirs. We're stopping everybody else. So now it looks like they're going to force a game 7. So, hey, it's going to be a good one. Whichever team, which team you think matches up better with Milwaukee in the next round? Because for me, I would say Philly.
It'll be Philly.
Yeah, I'll say Philly.
They're just a larger team. They're just bigger, more physical.
Yeah.
They can kind of play the shooting game, and if you want to, like, bully, then, you know, we just get a ball to Giannis. Let's see who can stop him.
It'll be a more physical matchup if you have them.
But they can throw more people at Giannis to at least, like, he can still get 30, but he's going to have to work his ass off for that 30.
Yep.
And he's not going to be able to play make. He's not going to be able to dish it to any open guys. Like, I'm making him basically fight through a Game of Thrones wall.
Facts.
Yeah.
Great show.
Never watched it.
Who's your favorite matchup?
You missing out.
I actually think Toronto is a better matchup than for Milwaukee than Philly. All right? Philly, although they're big, their starting five is big, right? And
yes.
It's unfair to include Boban because he's the biggest fucking dude on the court. But, like, in comparison, Toronto does have
big dudes. They might not be as big into like overall in comparison to Philly, but to me, Milwaukee's deeper. They are, and they got the outside shooting to match up with Toronto. Well, I mean, Milwaukee has the outside shooting to match up with Toronto, just as Toronto has outside shooting that's good enough to match up with them. And like the only thing I think that you guys are hitting on the head is the height advantage that Philly does over Milwaukee, and that's like overall, right?
Yeah.
But in terms of just pure matchup, I do think that the Bucks are better suited matchup wise to play against Toronto because of the specific players they have to defend specific positions. Like, you can put Kawhi and Siakam on Giannis and Chris Middleton, and those get covered. And then in terms of Serge Ibaka can match up with Brook Lopez, even though he's undersized, Serge Ibaka is still Serge Ibaka for what it is. Like, I think the matchups do work out. Danny Green's a hard-nosed defender and can add that pressure on either Brogdon, Bledsoe, or even George Hill. And I have to say George Hill because of that damn dunk. I'm going back to
Oh,
that
my
dunk.
God. He took it back. First of all, I ain't seen George Hill catch a what?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You thought I saw number 3 on the back of the jersey. I was like,
you got playoff Hill.
I thought it was Bledsoe at first. I'm like, wait,
he didn't even play like this last year in Cleveland.
I'm saying, who? First of all, what made you believe in yourself? I believed you
because
he
got his old coach.
Yeah,
that's the Spurs coach that's coaching him. He's literally playing in the same system he grew up in. He is so comfortable right now. And then he has no pressure on him because there's like 7 dudes better than him on the team, technically. Maybe 8 since Brogdon's back.
I agree. Hey, Courtside Radio here with the starting 5 in the building. Good News Radio, Good News Sports. It's Mike Kelder, PG. And, man, we're talking about these NBA playoffs, big time games. So if you guys watched last night's game, we're going to take it to the West Coast. Kevin Durant, who has been playing amazing, most points per game, 35.4 in the first 10 playoff games since Michael Jordan in 1992. He went down with an injury that a lot of people thought was an Achilles, but they come to find out it was just a strained calf.
Dude, you can't tell me that did not look like an Achilles.
No, it looked scary.
Like, as soon as he went to the ground, I'm like,
and did you guys get the Achilles update right when we walked in? What? That they said he will be back by the Western Conference.
Yeah,
they said potentially.
So if it goes 7, he's going to miss. They were able, I don't know how, I was so pissed. I was telling Alex how pissed I was that the Rockets didn't make it happen and steal that win. He got hurt with 10 minutes in the fourth.
They were down one.
They should have won. James Harden took one shot in the last 8 minutes of the game.
That is ridiculous.
It's crazy. Klay and Draymond, they were the big help for the Warriors. They made a lot of big-time shots, big-time plays.
Dude, Curry took over.
Yeah, Klay took over. He was out of bounds, just to let y'all know, for that last. I was getting intimate up in here.
I wasn't tripping. I saw that, too.
Are you trying to induce them having a lap dance from this
point? Yeah, it's getting real intimate in here, Jack. You better cut it out. Alex is a bad boy.
Jackie, just call me Puppy Chula.
You see, he already got his pants off.
Yeah, already got his pants off. Speedo
game. Speedo game.
Jackie, just call me Puppy Chula.
Hey, so
Puppy Chula.
The Rockets.
Hey, Puppy Chula.
To me, the Rockets have to win this series, or I think their run is done. They have a chance to go down as, like, the Nash-led Suns and the Chris Webber-led Sacramento Kings. Mm-hmm. So I think they have to win this game. They have to win this series. Like, the best player from the other team is out. Other than Steph, who else can really create? So if you just attack Steph, you make it tough.
Did you see how he played after KD went out? He looked like MVP Steph.
No, yeah, but now you can practice for that and really be ready.
It's gonna be tough. Unstoppable at one point in his career.
I was about to say, was it me or did you see the Splash Brothers back last night?
Yeah,
all three of KD, Steph, and then KD, Steph, and Klay. All three of them had 20 plus last night.
Yeah. Yep,
they all caught fire at some point in the game.
The one thing that we also need to know, and I got to mention it because I was his
speaking
biggest critic.
Speaking of
Mike,
homie.
Oh, the one thing I want to know is because I've been his biggest critic and we've all given him shit this year, is we all were sleeping on Draymond Green in the season, but the dude turned it up in the playoffs. Like, I got to give him at least some credit because he's actually stepped it up defensively and offensively. He's been able to spread the floor for them and turn himself from a guy who was shooting 4 air balls in a game against the Lakers in December to a guy who was able to do, like, a knockdown 3-point shooter at certain points in the game.
No, hey, he's their heart and soul, and he just brings that energy. And at home, it's really, really tough to beat him because of that energy, the confidence that he plays with. But I just think game six, I have the Rockets winning because I think the Rockets haven't lost a home game against Golden State in the playoffs, and they're going to be fired up knowing KD is not there. But, man, those guys, this was their chance to end the series. If they would have smelled blood and said, attack, attack. We're down 1 point. KD is out. Let's go out here. Kill him. James Harden, instead of taking one shot the last 8 minutes, bro, should have took 11 of them.
12.
Man, 12. Put your foot
CP,
on the throat.
But even the thing with go CP, ahead. Like, sorry, he CP was not aggressive. Neither one of them were aggressive. Like, our two best players. And CP is the guy that they brought in to initiate the offense in those moments when you know they're going to double James as soon as the ball is taken out of bounds, basically. So CP is there to kind of relieve the pressure, get some like pick and roll action going with Capella, kick it out. So you got Shumpert playing, Gordon playing, PJ playing. Somebody got to do something. And CP should be involved in every single assist on the floor for the last 10 minutes.
Agreed.
But what was he doing? Chilling in the back.
Yeah,
looking lost, cruising down the three, looking like he was in Space Jam coming up, and he lost his powers already.
Man,
I don't know what's going on with these folks anymore.
It's like they didn't smell the blood, and I don't know if it was D'Antoni.
How the hell are you going to lose that game?
Yeah, it's no way you lose that game.
That was horrible.
Yeah, it's like, no way you lose that
game. They don't deserve
it
at that point.
They could not buy a basket at the end of the game. Like, every time they would score a couple times, right, Golden State would come back and at least launch two threes that would go dead in, and they weren't able to get a defensive stop. Like, I don't know. I was really surprised. Like, as soon as KD went out, I looked at my count. I'm like, bro, this is done. Like, this is like, I feel like most
of us people did.
Yeah, a lot of people did. And yet they still won. And I'm like, oh, wait, that's right. The Golden State Warriors only lose if they lose Steph Curry. They don't lose if they lose KD.
Yeah. So, man, so who you guys have winning? You have you still got the Warriors escaping with no KD?
Let me tell you something. When I saw that Houston was 1-12 in the semis against, you know, at Oracle,
yeah,
I said, hey, that might be a defining little thing, because if you can't win at their home and
you gotta
they're
try
a better
to.
Team than you right now, even without their arguably best player, you got to understand, you're not going to get this one.
Yeah.
Go ahead, pack them up. But we believe in it going, but it ain't going to happen.
Man, I think this is the Rockets' opportunity. If not, I think their title window is closed. As Chris Paul is only getting older. You don't know who. Capella is looking like a bum. He's being outplayed.
What did I tell you earlier this season? They had the best midseason signing I've seen in months or years, and that man is literally Kenneth Faried, who is getting paid, I believe it's 96% less than Clint Capella. 96% of his contract is a complete difference. So he's getting paid like $3 or $4 million.
Yeah.
And his production level is way higher than Capella, yet they're not utilizing.
Yeah, they're not playing.
Yeah,
him
I don't
at
understand
all.
What happened.
They're not utilizing.
Oh. Are they scared? I mean, I feel like Kenneth Faried is a veteran. He's been in playoffs. Why isn't he getting any time?
I don't get it.
And I think this is the stuff that like separates certain coaches from the other ones. When you're taking chances on guys, and I've noticed in the last couple years that coaches just really won't use guys, and then you notice like last year Rodney Hood didn't get used until like the last three games, and then this year for Portland Rodney Hood is being used, and he looked good out there, and he looked that same way in the last two games for Cleveland. So it's like, what are these coaches like not doing? Is it the coaching? Is this guy, like, screwing up so bad that they just don't trust him? Are they scared? Is it defensive issues? Like, I like to know this stuff.
Yeah.
Because it looks bad when Kenneth Faried basically saved your ass the whole season, and then you just give him 0 minutes the rest of the year.
Yeah, I don't understand it. I coach basketball, and how I coach is my best guys are going to play, and I'm going to play you no matter what, no matter what you're doing, and he's one of the best guys, so I don't.
Oh, you never played me.
I got a follower said Rockets in seven, Rockets versus Bucks final.
Ooh, that'd be nice.
It would be.
It has okay. a chance.
Giannis you winning what? A ring if that's the case, though,
bro. Yeah. Because I said
you can't the best stop him. Bucks win,
bro. I'm,
yeah.
All right, so
I see you, Memo.
Okay, so I'm asking y'all, who y'all think is the best matchup for Milwaukee?
I literally said it.
It's Philly.
Are we talking about in terms?
No,
of
no, no.
East
I'm talking about overall West.
West.
If Milwaukee makes it. Who do you feel?
Golden State. KD's going to be back by then, so they'll be ready to go.
No, so that's their best. That's the team you feel like they can beat.
No, the team they can beat any team other than Golden State.
That's what I'm saying.
No,
like,
I think they can beat Golden State.
I feel like they can
beat anybody, but Golden State will be tough compared to the other team.
That's what I'm saying. Golden State will be their toughest matchup.
That's why I think it's the best, because you literally have Giannis versus KD. That's what everyone wants to see, right?
That would be perfect. But that's what should, that's what I believe will happen, because I don't think Houston doesn't match up well enough with Milwaukee to stop them. Which is
both of those teams got to get there first. So they might have to get past one of these teams that's playing later on tonight, especially the away team, man. The Denver Nuggets are up in this series 3-2. Last game, game 5 in Denver. Denver led by as much as 31 points. 124-98 win. The stats were crazy. You had 25, 6 assists, 19 rebounds from Jokic. 24-8 from Millsap. 18-9-5 from Murray, and Gary Harris chipped in with 16 points. Man, when it comes down to Portland, they're just not looking like that team in the first round.
Dame just looked tired.
I think he gave so much. Yeah, he gave so much to beating Russ and the Thunder that he doesn't have it the same. Jokic, to me, is proving that he is the best big in the NBA.
Philip is
with
saying
this series.
Bucks, Houston.
Bucks, Houston.
Yep, that's what Phillips said.
Well, Giannis, get your ring.
Hey, Denver's looking nice. Paul Millsap went from averaging 11 points in the first round to 19 points a game versus Portland.
Oh, can I say something real quick? I'm sorry to interrupt.
No, you got it.
I have to do this, all right? So a good buddy of mine in high school, right, when I was really like, you know when you're in high school and like the only thing you really have to do is like fuck off, like you're not really going to do homework, you're just going to sit there and kind of watch NBA games, like that point where you're just like.
No, I did my homework, bro.
Yeah, well, once a year doesn't really count, but like, you know what I mean, where you can just sit there and just watch games, like each game back to back to back, not care.
Yeah.
Just that's what you do. So I told my buddy Matt Yamodim, and I'm telling him right now, if he's listening, in high school, Paul Millsap was going to be an all-star. You know what happened 3 nights later?
He's an all-star?
No. The Miami-Utah game where he went off and everyone found out who Paul Millsap was when he hit 4 threes back-to-back-to-back-to-back-to-back to get them that win. All these years later, Paul Millsap was an all-star.
Paul Millsap is abusing Portland right now.
Yeah, yeah. He's killing them. They have nothing.
Nothing. They're throwing every single person at him, and he's like, bro, you know what? The answer.
I feel like Paul Millsap is a big small forward.
No, that's what he is.
Like, literally, that's what he plays like. Yeah, he's just a big, small forward.
No, so, he's a small power forward.
Small power forward.
He's more of a big man. He got the big man game. He can step out, but he's not like cutting, slashing. He's literally just walking you down, backing you down, overpowering you, hit you with the hezzy a little bit in the paint. Like, everything's between 10 and 12 feet probably at the most.
And rebounding.
Or 2 feet.
Yeah, rebounding is top notch. Yeah. But Portland has to get more in tonight's game. They're at home, so I expect them to play much better. But they got game 5, you got 22 points from Dame and 12 from CJ. Like, your best players can't combine for 34 points, and you think you're going to beat
a tough Denver team.
But
they can't do it. They don't have any answers. Dame Lillard literally has to do every single play, pick and roll, and then, like, just – outrun his opponent with his first step.
Yeah.
That is exhausting,
then
bro.
Then he has to guard Jamal Murray, who's not backing off.
Now, Jamal plays no defense, and he's terrible on defense.
Yes.
But he is cooking these dudes right now.
Yeah, he's playing more consistent, and that makes them a tougher team because Jokic is going to give you 20-10 and possibly 10, you know, most of the games. Then if Paul Millsap is back to balling where he's about 17 a game, if Murray is like 16, 17 with the assists, man, it just opens up the court for everybody else. So that's why guys like Gary Harris can come in and knock down shots. You know, their bench, which plays well, especially at home, is going to be tough. So think about this. If Houston were to somehow win that series, which they have a good chance to, the Denver Nuggets have home court advantage.
Yeah.
So, man, if they win just 4 home games, they're in the finals. So, hey, look out for the Denver Nuggets. Hines, what you think about this series? How do you think it finishes? And, man, what you think about Denver and Jokic, man?
If we go back and listen to some of the old shows, I said that Denver was a team I thought was going to go to the Western Conference Finals from the jump because of how good they were. The only thing I had against them was that they're a fresh team, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know how we always say, like, you can't really, even if it's a first, like, first or second seed, you can't always count on it. Like, look at Denver when they had Iguodala and they were, like, one or two, how that turned out, right?
Yeah.
But for me, like, Jokic is that big of a difference maker. He's got the blend of what this new era of basketball is plus old school. He's got the old school in the sense that he's a big, and he does have mild post moves. Mild, yeah, right?
To the basket,
but he's
game.
Got the new evolution stuff where he's a ball handler. He's a big. His body is awkwardly shaped, which makes him more of a mismatch for some of these guys.
Yeah.
And he can stretch the floor from any angle.
Shoot the three.
He's a facilitator.
That's yes, his that best too. Quality. The fact that he's a facilitator, it's not even the fact that the guy can shoot, right? It's yeah. the fact that he can facilitate makes him that much more of a threat. So some of these teams in the West are going to go up to it. Like Golden State, if they face Denver, right, I would have said they would have had a better time with Cousins because that's at least a guy who's at least 300 pounds. And if I'm Jokic, the last guy I want to see down low is DeMarcus Cousins.
Yeah,
right?
Big body. Yeah.
But
and
now
he's physical.
Yeah.
Extra physical.
And now I know the three guys I'm going to face are an undersized dude in Draymond who I can pass over. I can at least body up and definitely outplay Kevon Looney. There's no offense to him.
No, yep. But true.
And then the easiest one, which is the guy you want to be matched up against, and that's Bogut.
Yeah, true.
Right? Like, they're a mismatch for a lot of these teams. Like, even if they play Houston, Houston can throw Capella at him. They can throw P.J. Tucker. They can throw Fareed. Don't matter.
Yeah, it's not
He's
enough.
A problem. That's why it's his play that made this series change. Like, as soon as Jokic was having the triple doubles, like Mike said, that's when we're all like, oh, Portland is playing well, but, like, they have no Nurkic. They're relying on Enes Kanter, who is very present offensively, but as soon as you get to the other side of the court, it's like
defensive
playing 4-on-5.
Yep.
So I got Denver winning this series, even though I want Portland to. I really am rooting for Portland because I can't help but root for Dame. He deserves it. He deserves that credit. Shout out to Oaktown.
Hey, Alex, where your pants at?
Yeah. Hey, 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 I can't even hate, though. Speedo Alex is better on the mic than regular Alex. So
the pants was holding him up.
Yeah, the
holding
the
them back.
Pants was holding him back.
Sorry, bro, you got to wear pants.
Yeah.
Care.
All right, I want you guys to see this. This photo right
We've
here
seen
straight
enough.
Up looks like I have nothing on.
Yeah.
I don't want to see
no,
that.
No, what he looks like is John. Ew, he looks like
bro.
John Stockton back in the day playing.
That's true.
Yeah,
that's the shorts they wore.
Yeah, that's the shorts
they really
wore.
That's small. Oh,
hey,
so,
that goes. Hey, make sure you guys.
Someone get a photo of me right now. And
you like a little IG
on,
thigh.
No, no, no. Someone take a photo of me right now and tag Lonzo Ball in their story with this post so they know.
You look like an IG thought that woke up in her dude's jersey.
Yeah.
And that's all she got on is the
Facts.
Jersey.
Hey, Bruce, you preaching, bro.
I look like the type of girl you call an Uber for at 8 a.m.
Not hey, even eight. Now you out by eight. Five for sure.
Damn,
you
bro.
Out by five. Sun can't come
That's
up before
petty
you.
Shit.
We gotta get you out of here.
Hey, my boy Bruce is killing it once again on the ones and twos. We up in here with John Stockton in the building. We call him Heinz World. Da-dum. Came in here with his.
I'll take Mark Price. Da-dum. I'll take Mark Price.
Almost his G string, but hey, we
you
having
like
fun.
It.
The playoffs is. It's exciting so far, man. A lot of big-time games coming up. But we are in L.A. We got to talk about the craziness that's going on with the Lakers. So if you haven't heard, the Lakers tried to hire Tyronn Lue but failed miserably. The Lakers offered him 3 years for $18 million. Ty Lue said, no, I want 5 years, $50 million. They couldn't come to an agreement. The Lakers missed out on him. The Lakers didn't expect Monty Williams to choose Phoenix over them, but it happened. So if you haven't heard, fans are expected to protest outside of Staples Center tomorrow due to displeasure with the front office after, you know, the Tyronn Lue fail. So, man, I'm a Lakers fan. I love the Lakers to death. Been loving them
you
since.
You know how I feel.
Yeah, so. Since birth. They need to figure this thing out. And
I'm trying to tell you.
I don't know where they're going to go. Y'all, you guys help me out because I'm lost. I'm the PG. I don't
I
know where to go.
I get real, and I'm a Laker fan. You know I'll make excuses all day. We're a shit show. We're a dumpster fire. We look like bums. And honestly, it's mainly just the perception that we're giving off. We don't really know what's going on behind the scenes. Pay Ty Lue 5 years. Why not?
Hey, they're doing that for
every other coach. I get why you're like trying to like get into some like, bro, like y'all will pay a coach just like every other team does. You pay
you
him five,
fire him.
They go three. Like that's it. Mm-hmm. If he does good, then good. You got him locked down for $6 million a year. Because by the time that third and fourth year roll around, it's like $9 million a coach probably by then. You guys started the whole trend with Luke Walton and gave him 5. Then now there's 6. By then, it'll be 7, 8, 9. So
easily.
Make the deal. And it's the right deal for the team. He was agreeing to like having the coaches on staff. It had nothing to do with the coaches they were trying to bring on. That's fine. Bring Frank Vogel. Bring Jason Kidd. Whatever you got to do. I don't think it's the whole Rambis's thing that's a problem, anything like that. I just think that the Lakers have their heads so far up their ass and think that their shit doesn't stink to where, like, they think that they dictate everything. And, like, nah, bro, like, you guys are desperate at this point. And you need the best candidate available.
I just think the Lakers, man, that LeBron thing hurt us because what coaches really want to come and coach LeBron knowing that he wants so much control?
Honestly, you got LeBron. Has to do with that, bro.
You inherit the job with benefits already.
Hey, like you have the best player in the last 20 years or 15 years or whatever it might be.
That's the thing. He's only getting older.
He is, but he's still at a good point in his brain and like his smarts and his knowledge of the game is something you cannot teach any other person in the league. And I don't think smarts wise and like his IQ on the basketball floor, I don't think anybody still compares to what he brings.
No, yeah, his knowledge.
You guys
yeah.
want the real story?
What's the real
story?
What you got? You said you had inside info.
You got inside.
It's good, Himes.
Never reveal sources, but from what I've heard, the reason why Ty Lue isn't the Lakers head coach is because some of the stuff you mentioned, but more stuff in the backside. Lue wanted the 5 years, right? Yeah. The Lakers were okay with that originally. Conceptually speaking, it makes sense because all you have to do if LeBron retires or things don't work out, right? You just straight up fire a guy. I mean, that's what you do.
Yeah.
You just fire a guy. Makes it easy. Yeah, you pay him, but you get rid of him. At least it shores up an immediate fix. The Lakers were all set to make a move and sign Lue. They had coaching staff picked out. Moves were already ready to be made. They were already doing stuff in the rooms. But Linda and Kurt Rambis, Laker legend, they had say, and they nixed the deal. They said they didn't think that Lue would be a great coach to have after LeBron. So they suggested that the Lakers do a 3-year deal that matches LeBron's deal. But because of job security purposes, makes sense. Lou wants the rest of the money, wants the 5 years.
Yeah, it's a smart move.
So for his side, he thought, you know, I'll just stay firm. I'll get the job. It doesn't matter, right?
Yeah.
But what ended up transpiring is Jeannie Buss sided with Linda and Kurt Rambis.
It's their best friend.
Which leaves only 3 coaching candidates from what I've heard on the table, and none of which are who you guys should get. You guys have Mike Woodson, Jay Kidd, and
Lionel Hollins.
Don't forget about Frank Vogel.
Frank Vogel.
No, he's off the list.
No, he interviewed yesterday or today.
He interviewed yesterday, but he's off the list now. It's those 3 names that I gave you.
What's crazy is Kobe has came out.
You're a Laker fan, bro. Like, just admit.
Man, I'm the one that showed up in a damn Speedo and a jersey.
Because you're a Laker fan.
I should burn this damn jersey.
Nah, don't you dare.
I'll give you a stitched one at least.
Hey, we'll kill you.
No, that's why I brought you that, because it was like the low budget joint.
Hey, but I'm hearing Kobe.
I'm a cheap whore now.
Yeah, exactly.
I really am the morning after.
You back page before there was back page.
Oh, papi chulo. Call me 300 pesos for good time.
You were the ones that called from the back of the magazine.
Hey,
type.
Bro, we got different races listening to us, man. Don't do that. Hey, but
okay, fine. This peen is kosher. How about that? Now we cover the Jewish base.
Oh man, this guy is a problem. Shalom hey, but hey, I actually Shalom heard that that Kobe is pushing for Lionel Hollins. Like he's like, yeah, I'll mess with Lionel Hollins. So, hey,
we'll see.
If Kobe agrees, we agree. I guess
they should hire one coach and one coach only. And I've steadfast said this. And I think you guys would agree, and it's Mark Jackson.
Yeah, Mark Jackson would be.
I can see that.
It's
Mark
a crime.
Jackson is not up for the job. Can stop saying that?
Yeah, he's not up for the job.
Look, it's a crime, though, that he's not a coach.
Yes,
it's a crime that it's not a coach.
Fire.
We know.
Hey, I think, man, I coach basketball. I need to go interview up there, see if I can.
Get your, I'll be your head assistant.
Yeah, you'll be my head assistant. But y'all be my assistants. Y'all down?
We'll do it. The whole staff will do it. The whole course I start 5 do it for $10 million.
Michael,
we'll split it up.
Yeah, $10 million.
We're not talking about AAU coaching. We're talking about NBA coaching, buddy.
But AAU and NBA is
and we'll
closer
find a trainer. Don't even worry. We'll find a trainer.
Yeah, we'll find a trainer.
Shit, I got the Speedo on. I'm ready to do some training.
Hey, facts.
I don't know about that, bro.
We got our training.
You're not allowed. No, you can't come.
Yeah, because that Celtics green got to go away, disappear for a long time.
Say but, goodbye to the Speedo, bro.
Hey, we got to make sure we take pictures, man. Himes has to get out here. Pops,
oh, that's right.
Pops is turning, what is he, 25 today?
25 again.
27? Yeah, he's turning 27, so he's going to celebrate Pops, man. So Himes will be leaving the building. Hey, make sure you don't take the Speedo off. You got to take pictures, Jackie.
He got to leave right now, he said.
Hey, come on, hurry up, man. Take pictures in front of the good news. You got to do it. Don't be weird.
Get out here. Nope, take
go
them
back.
Off.
Hurry
nope.
up.
Sorry.
So
do
we can
again.
Post you, man. We about to get famous off of this guy.
You about to go viral, kid.
Hey, so a good thing Alex.
I post this shit everywhere. I want this shit out.
Yes, a good thing Alex is out of here because he have no idea
have
what the good answer is.
You have to hold the jersey up just a little
for
bit
for this
so
next topic. Hey, so our next topic is going to be about the shoe game.
Sweaty balls.
Hey, so tell me, I need you guys to let me know, what are your top 5 hoop shoes to hoop in. So
right.
I'm going to give you the list from Bleacher Report. I'm going to just give you their top 10.
Mm-hmm.
And they went through history, so they took it all the way back.
Mm-hmm.
So at number 10, you had the Huaraches.
2K4s?
Yeah.
That's definitely up there for me. That's Huaraches,
you had, that was the number 10. Number 9, you had the Converse Weapons, which were Magic Johnson, Larry Bird shoes in the 80s.
Uh-huh.
What's crazy about the Huaraches was they were supposed to be Kobe shoes, but he didn't. Nike didn't make it his shoe.
But make
because
sure
of
you
the,
mention the Huarache 2K4s.
Yeah, Huarache 2K4s were going to be the Kobe 1s, but because of the Colorado incident, they was like, we can't do that. So they just made it the Huarache 2K4s.
Kobe's still warm. He's still.
Yeah, he's still warm, so he still played in them. Yeah. So, number 8, the Reebok Questions on Bleacher Report. Mm. So, the Reebok Questions. Number 7, the Nike Zoom Kobe 6s.
Okay.
So, those are...
Never hooped in Kobe's other than... never hooped in Kobe's.
I have, but those are my brothers because one day I leave my kicks at, you know, mm-hmm. we go to the gym. We talk shit. I can run you. Get you buckets.
Beat him up.
Oh, he's disrespectful. Oh, hey, Alex, we're beating up Alex. Yeah, we're beating Alex up today.
He just stomped out.
Hey, so Air Jordan, what's that? The 13s is number 6. Number 5, the Air Penny 2s.
Wait, the Jordan 6 was number 13? The 13s were Jordan.
Number 6.
Number 6.
Okay. Yeah. To hoop in?
Yeah.
Yeah, to hoop in.
Damn.
Number 5, the Air Penny 2s.
I like those.
Number 4, the Jordan 11s, which are iconic.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Number 3, I don't know how this is up there, but I guess people did wear them. I know Rasheed wore them a lot.
Forces?
And it's heyday Air Forces.
Bruh, I'm
to
telling
hoop in.
The high tops. I didn't hoop in them, but I know a lot of people I've
Forces,
seen.
Hands down, probably like they're in my top 5 as a hoop shoe.
Okay,
but the extra sole and like the cushion they had inside.
Yeah.
And then like just the sturdiness of the shoe.
Yeah. That's
never
crazy.
Never knew. It had a strap.
Bruh. Get especially the highs.
Get the highs.
Oh, my God.
But because it's also throwback, you know, they did their all-around top 10. Number 2 was the Chuck Taylors, the originator.
Yes.
Okay.
I hooped in the low top.
It said the number 1 basketball shoe to wear is to hoop in is Air Jordans. The 1s.
The Jordan 1s?
Jordan 1s, yeah.
Man, get out of here with
get
that.
Get out of here. Exactly.
About so to break my ankle.
Hey, so we're gonna give our top 5. Mike, you want to start? Yeah.
I'll start. Your top
5 basketball shoes to hoop in.
You know what? Back in the day, I would take one of them. This is no order, also.
Okay.
Because you know you have to like switch them up, like you switch. You know, like you switch kicks.
Yes, sir.
So I would say Huaraches back in the day.
I would say the 2K. Where you get that?
Hey, shout out Alex, bro, with the Crenshaw hoodie on, man,
with the leather jacket on top.
I didn't even know you knew who Nipsey was, bro. I'm proud of you.
Bro, we had
to tell him.
No, yeah, I know.
Yeah,
he knew.
He did some research before. Yeah. So
no, I told you how it was.
Yeah, he just didn't know the music. You see, he knew Nip as a person.
No, yeah.
I knew of Nip, but I knew his music. Until
he knew of Nipsey, but he didn't know the music.
Yeah, like he didn't know his music extensively. You know, so it's okay.
Yeah, but so your top 5, you said the 2K4s.
I would say those old Huaraches. I remember those. I would definitely have to say the Kyrie 2s was a very, you know, like most recent, if we're going all time, like that was, I got a lot of bucks on those randomly.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll say back in the day, we're going to go with the, Ooh, you know what? I'm going to go with the foams.
Oh,
I used
yeah,
to hoop in the foams sometimes.
Nah, I'm not hooping in $20 shoes.
Like, that's, nah. I didn't even hear you. That's crazy.
Yeah, no. So, foams, what are some other ones?
You know what? I would say back in the day, the LeBrons. I'm trying to remember the black and red joints.
The originals?
The with the
LeBron ones, the Zoom Generation ones?
Zoom no, Generation. Not the black, white, and red ones. Not the first ones. You said Zoom Generation.
Yeah, that's what they
called. Had a strap, so I can't remember. You know, they were heavy, though. I remember that.
Yeah.
It made me, his first, LeBron's Boots. First set of shoes. I remember that. And then I'm going to have to go with, I'm going to have to throw some Jordans in there just because they were the Aqua 8s. The eights in general, but then the Aqua
8s are a great hoop
because they're comfortable.
Yeah,
and they're sturdy. I liked them because they were mid high. You feel me?
My favorite shoe to hoop in, Hyperdunks, the first pair.
Oh, hold on, can I get an honorable mention?
Yeah,
I'm sorry. The Hyperflights.
Hyperflights.
Back in the day, yes, the Hyperflights.
It was horrible to hoop in, but yeah, they get out. But Hyperdunks was like I would say was my number one. Number two is Jordan 12s. Because they were like not as crazy heavy, but I like 12 is my favorite shoe. And honestly, I only hooped in J's up until like Hyperdunks dropped. Like honestly, like I might have hooped in like a couple things here and there. But for the most part, whatever Jordan was out at the time, I've hooped in every shoe from the 12 probably to the 16. Like as my hoop shoe. I remember I even hooped in the blue 15 lows, the 14 lows, the 14, 15.
Y'all remember
had the 15s, some ugly ass ones that came with the little tongue out or whatever.
You remember the Dubs though?
Nah, I didn't hoop in Dubs. No.
What's up, Hans?
No. Last thing I want to say, thank you guys for having me today again. Well, I'm on the show. Never mind. What? I'm about to leave, guys, because I got to go something. I want to give a nice shout out to my dad. Happy birthday, Pops. I love
Happy
you.
Birthday, Pops.
Happy birthday,
Pops.
His birthday was May 7th. My mom's birthday was 4/20. So,
She blazed. He blazed.
Yeah. So, happy birthday, Dad. I'll see you in a few minutes. You're probably not listening, but it doesn't matter. Shout out to you guys. Thank you for putting up for me twerking in a Speedo, which I don't think anyone would ever want to see.
Hey, no, thanks for respecting the bed, bro. So,
man, yeah, you definitely I'm a man
get,
of my
you
word.
Get, you get love for that.
Hey, shout out to all the Game of Thrones fans. Ahimes always pays his debts.
Yeah. Ah, I like that. Like Lannisters. I like it. But you got more shoes?
Let's see. So I had Hyperdunks and pretty much every single Jordan there between 12 and 16, I think. Because after the 13, they went to more like a, I think that was when like it went like weird with MJ, and it was like the crazy, like the Ferrari looking shoe, and then this shoe, and then that shoe. But I'll say I had the 12s, Hyperdunks, Jordan 13s, Air Force 1s, and I haven't hooped in them, but I tried them on. Last year's Harden.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
actually
yeah.
was like really, it was a snug shoe, but it had a hell of a lot of cushion on the inside, and it felt sturdy. I'm all about like the sturdiness of a shoe to make sure like I know I can do things.
Yeah,
I
don't hurt myself.
Like, because certain shoes, that, like them Kobe's, when you put them on, it feels like there's nothing there. Like, not in a good way. Like,
yeah.
There's no support on the bottom. Like, I feel like I'm going to have blisters after wearing this shoe.
So, do y'all remember the old Mellows back in the day? Was it the 2.5?
I know what you're talking about.
I used to love those. I'm
those
sorry.
Those look like, because they look like a boot.
Bro, and they were, those were the ones that were sturdy, but they were light.
Yeah.
It was like the Kobe, the Mellow 2.5s, if I remember right. Yeah. My brother K-Mac put me on the Mellow game back in the day because that was his favorite player. Yeah. He will smash anybody I'll put money on in 2K.
Yeah.
Back in the day for Mellow.
No, you know what? I need to take one back.
I got mine after this.
Go ahead.
The Iverson, it came out in like, when I was like 5th grade. So those are the questions. It was probably the answers. They recently redropped, and they had a whole bunch of like the RBX bubbles at the bottom. It was like one of their new technologies. Most comfortable shoe I ever had in my life. It was Iverson. It said like I3 up to
I'm gonna tell y'all, he's lying. I know
they're like talking second
about.
Or third, but it's like around that time. Like those, hit, like they felt like you was walking on like clouds.
Hey, so. Hey, Jackie,
Adidas mean nothing to you, man.
Oh, pro models.
Hey, like, we got the lady of the ladies' night in the building.
Mrs.
And I know that she likes to rock a lot of tennis shoes, so I'm going to have to get yours ready. Get you some shoes ready.
Let us see the
What
camera.
Do you play softball in?
I'm not a sneakerhead, though.
Yeah, I know you want to be a sneakerhead. Me neither.
What were your top five kicks?
What are your top kicks to play
She's a softball goddess.
But you don't play. You don't play cleats. Softball with your sneakers.
You have your cleats on. Y'all be that serious?
You don't play on turf.
I need to get some turf shoes, but I don't. I have cleats right now.
Really?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
All right, hey. So just give us
red Air Maxes right now.
Air Max.
What is your favorite tennis shoe right now?
What are your favorite tennis shoe to rock right now?
Well, I have these, and then I have the yellow. I don't even know what they're called because I'm not a sneakerhead. I took my goddaughter to help me buy some sneakers.
What do they look like?
They're like the new Nike ones right now. They're like
Vapor Max?
All yellow. I don't even know what they're called.
Oh, is it the one with the little, just like, what are they?
Bubbles everywhere?
No, what are they called? They're the ones, they're like 175.
They're
like the really nice ones. 270s?
270s?
I will say this, though. There was these one shoes by Kyrie Irving that I really wanted. I never got, and they were black and red. I don't know. They were like these, like maybe like they were about 5 years ago.
So it was probably
his first round.
Probably his first ones.
They were like spikes on the side.
Yeah, those were first ones. Kyrie ones.
Red and black. You have those? Yeah. Oh, no, they were red and black, though. Those were dope. Yeah. I was like, I'm not a sneaker person, but I like
those.
With
the spikes on them.
Yeah, the Kyrie ones. So let me... So we do have the lady of the ladies' night in the building.
Hey.
Every Friday at 7:30, y'all. Check me out.
Yes, sir. Hey, she's in here showing us much love, doing the camera work. She's the greatest. So my five to hoop in, I kind of bunched the Jordans together. So I say the threes. I love the threes because they're so light. So I like the threes to play in them. The ones because, you know, when they fresh, the grip is A1, and you just got to tie them pretty snug, and they'll fit right on there. I like the look of the 11s when I'm playing in them, but
yeah,
they're
I'm
heavy.
Not, I'm not hooping them.
Yeah, they're
I'm
heavy,
not,
so I hoop
I wasn't
in them.
Doing it.
Yeah, I hoop in them sometimes.
I'm all about being fly.
I even hoop in my Space Jam, so I make sure my Space Jams are ready. But for me, like, so other than those Jordans, the Reebok questions, yeah. I remember being younger, hooping in those. It just made you feel like AI. You had to cross up some when you rocked them. So those are a clutch.
Like I rocked you.
Never. hey,
bait.
Adidas Pro Models, you brought them up, Bruce. Them were some of my favorite shoes. They were
as a
so
true
light.
Hooper, I know. I've only played with them a couple times because I had to borrow somebody's shoes.
Yeah.
But I know, like, basketball folks, like, die by that shoe.
Bro, grip was amazing.
They tried to bring them back because Nick Young was wearing them.
Yeah.
They tried to bring them back a couple when he was on the Warriors.
Yeah. Wait, which ones?
The Adidas Pro
Adidas
Models.
Pro Models.
Okay.
Because remember, LeBron used to wear them at... St. Vincent, St. Mary. Yeah, so those shoes are so light, so comfortable. Man, the grip was amazing. The Kobe 11 Elites. I know you said you haven't hooped in Kobe, but those shoes,
really.
I like shoes.
Is that the high top one?
No, they're like, you know, they're snug. You can get them at high top, but I like them low top. Man, they're so comfortable, dog. Like,
was
they're so light.
The knit?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. The ones when he after he tore his Achilles, though, that was the high top?
Yeah.
The lows you're talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, I love those. They're so light. It's like you're playing in your socks when you're playing with those. So, I'm like, damn, that's why Kobe be flying and dunking everything.
Random question, since you brought up dunking.
Uh-huh.
Well, how old was everyone when you first dunked?
Dunked what?
What?
Basketball?
Yeah.
I was, no lie, I was able to catch a lob. I couldn't never just go up and dribble and dunk because I couldn't really palm the ball. But I got to a point to where I can go and catch a lob.
You know,
so, I was in college for that.
Okay. That makes sense because I had a problem palming it in the air. I could palm it on the ground but could not palm it in the air.
Because you got to bring it back.
Bro, they said that was my problem because I can get up there. I hit this. They was like, you keep trying to throw it in too hard.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, what does that mean? Y'all said go up and throw it down. So I'm trying to bang it.
You're supposed to just take it
up
with you. And then
so, bro, they was
put
like,
it in the hoop.
They said just go ahead and throw it. They was like, when you get up there, act like you're doing a layup and just... Like, bro, I'm like, bro, it's not. It feels weird, man. I got to bang on somebody. This ain't how this goes down.
And that's why I love the Kobe's because they were so light on your feet. It was like, bro, I can just jump, and it was effortless.
Iverson DMX is the answer. DMX is
there. You go.
DMX.
And then my them look trash. I remember those. Hey, but my final shoe was the LeBron, the Air Zoom Generations. Those are actually light when
they
first came out. The Air Zoom Generations were actually really dope.
I had
these.
Those,
yeah. I had the black and gold ones.
I remember that.
Hey, they fire. I had them in red, white, and blue. I was at Losinger, so you know I had to.
Of course.
So they were fly, man. I love those. So those would be my shoes. But my favorite would probably be either the Kobe 11 Elites or the Pro Models. Like, if I made it to the league, I'd be like, bro, I got to get some type of... I would have signed with Nike and said, I want y'all to make it feel like the Pro Models because them shoes were amazing, bro.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I have to give a huge shout out to Baron Davis him and Stevie Franchise had some of the most comfortable and well-built shoes to hoop in back in the day.
When they did that, like, combo shoe for them?
Do you understand? When they had, it was him, Kenyon Martin, and them. Oh, okay, I can see you with
yeah,
them. I
the
can
LeBron
see
ones, them. Yeah. That was icy.
They had the, it was like a whole street, not like street ball, but it was like the whole, but it was like, it was freestyle basketball.
Yeah,
Baron
yeah.
Baron Davis, Stevie Franchise, Kenyon Martin, Drew Gooden. Wow, I remember Drew Gooden being in there.
Wow.
That's crazy. Like, bro, Reebok had some, they had some people that used to put in that work with the
kid
game.
I will say, one random shoe I hooped in was these ugly ass Shaqs. They were super ugly. They was like wow. All patent. And they was like white. And they came out after the
kamikazes?
Yeah, after the kamikazes, they was these ugly ass shoes. They looked like robots on my feet. Comfortable.
Well,
hell no.
Hey, so that's the next thing. What first of all, let me shout out my pick, my Philadelphia 76ers for this playoff run. They got that win, 112-101, led by Jimmy Butler, 25-8-6. Simmons showed up with 25-6-8.
Ooh.
Embiid 17-12. Tobias 16-9. JJ Redick 11. Scott 11. Kawhi chipped in for the Raptors 29. They got 21 from Siakam. Not much from anyone else. So game seven, we got a game seven for this round. Let's see what this Denver Portland game looked like. But now, what was the worst basketball shoe you wore? For me, I don't know why. I remember my parents one time. I don't remember why I got them. I was a Stephon Marbury fan. So I was like, let me get these Starberries and
what?
Ones. And them shits were terrible.
Terrible,
dog.
Oh, my God.
I couldn't believe it. But I wore them for like a week, and I was like, that's
the orange,
it.
Wait, you have the blue and orange ones?
No, I had the.
So you get out of here.
No,
right
I
now.
Had the white and they were blue like ones? White and blue. Yeah.
White and blue.
With the star was. With yeah. Hey, there was.
Wait, okay.
I thought I was the man because I was my guy.
Hey, Starberry was cold. But I will say Kobe's moon boots back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
Bro, those were garbage.
Those ranked as top 100 on Bleacher Report.
I remember
those
I'm
shoes.
Telling you, like,
I used to hate
comfort.
Them shoes.
I was about
to
say, those are hella comfortable.
Comfort, bro. I was all about comfort when I was hooping.
Shout out Frank, the only white dude in Inglewood who was giving people buckets back in the day.
With those
and Kobe boom boots. Bro, he used to wear Jordans, and he was a Kobe fanatic, so he used to have all of Kobe's kicks. Bro.
Hey, I am not letting Neil Armstrong serve me on the court with
his
boots
on. He was a point guard.
Man, that's crazy.
Never
hey,
know,
so
Sean.
Your worst shoe, mine's was that, I remember that Starberry shoe.
Mine, like I said, I only hooped in a very few amount of shoes, but the Jordan 14s.
Oh, okay.
I hated it because I felt like they was like a mid-cut. Narrow. The tongue always went to the side.
Yes.
And then like there was like these little points on the end of the tongue that would just scratch you.
Yeah.
And you know, back then you always wore the no-show socks. So
yeah,
you
yeah,
was
yeah.
just getting like... scratched up on the ankle the whole time, and they was, but then the low tops came, and I was like, I can actually hoop in these lows. I don't know why I was hooping in lows, but
yeah.
I just wanted to be fly on the court. I was playing for the Warriors at Rancho at the time,
okay,
and I had the Royal Blue and Yellow joints too to go with it. So, you know,
oh,
I
yeah,
to
yeah,
trip
yeah.
on the court a little bit, but only wore them like twice, and I went back to whatever.
Yeah,
I
love them was fly though.
You know what? My worst shoes to hoop in were the twos. I was just mad that I hooped in them.
Oh yeah,
the twos back in the day.
I don't think I've ever hooped in twos. I hooped in nines. Nines was
you
dope.
Know what. I have hooped in some ones before.
Yeah, nah, I'm not hooping in ones.
I don't remember why. Like, it was
I'm not
just
hooping
a couple
in nothing.
Times.
I hooped in a pair of Vans one time and, like, damn near tore my ankle.
Bro, side note, I used to be able to hoop in Chucks and house shoes and give people action. But, like, I was.
Get out of here. Now he just
I'm
making
not
it.
Playing.
Who
I'm
was he
not
playing against?
Corduroy house shoes.
Bro,
yeah.
I'm not playing.
Like, yeah, you know, I had the rebels on. And, you
no,
know,
bro, that was, no, and the,
he was like,
and
bro,
the house shoe joints, that was just be giving niggas, like, nigga buckets.
Hey, bro, was like.
That was nigga buckets. But in the Chucks, it was like randomly, they will fit so I could hoop like it was regular. It was so random. But
hey,
I wouldn't go in the game like
hey,
that.
Hey, since he bringing that up, bro, I used to be in a Hush Puppy serving dudes. Have
bro,
my blue ones.
You can do whatever you feel like on a court, nigga. I see you like hell, but if we talk about.
I have my blue Hush Puppies on. I was serving.
Okay, so when y'all trying to go, we can go
hey,
anywhere.
We've been waiting,
to, yeah, we got to set up a hoop. We're going to set up a
we
hoop.
We have a gym. We have the keys to Rancho at all times.
Yes.
So,
Rancho?
Again, yes. Again,
they
we
back
told
open?
We'll talk about
wait,
that.
Wait, Rancho on Rodeo? On Obama?
On Obama
Boulevard?
Well, I don't know.
We'll talk about it.
All right. Yeah, I didn't know that because I thought hey, they was going to shut that down.
So the hoop run's going to be going up. Be prepared for it. So before we get up out of here, you know, every Thursday we bring to you the Throwback Thursday Player of the Week, which is just, you know, a flashback of a player. You can check our IG to go check out some highlights. You can check for this player and past players so you can see who our Throwback Thursday players has been.
We just give you a player from the past, 2000s era, 90s era, 80s era, maybe even 70s, just so you guys can be like, oh, yeah, I remember that guy. That dude was nice. He gave good highlights. So this week's Throwback Thursday Player of the Week is The Matrix, man. Sean Marion is our Throwback Thursday Player of the Week. Career averages 15 points, 8 rebounds, 1 steal, 1 block. Four-time All-Star, 2010-2011 champ for the Dallas Mavericks when they beat LeBron and the Miami Heat. Two-time All-NBA player, 1999-2000 All-Rookie Team. His best year statistically was 05-06. He averaged 21 points, 11 rebounds, 2 steals, and nearly 2 blocks. So he was putting up numbers.
Phoenix?
Yeah, he was a part of that Phoenix team who really brought – back to running gun, kind of like what you saw with.
What you mean, kind
of? With Matt. I'm just saying, you saw some of that with Showtime. You saw it with Hank Gathers' team at LMU. So rest in peace, Hank Gathers. So Sean Marion, man, the Matrix is our Throwback Thursday Player of the Week. I just remember that guy because he had the worst looking form, but he would make that shot. And he had crazy bounce, and he was a part of that
crazy
Phoenix
bounce.
Hey,
he was one of the first guys I knew that had bounce that was able to develop like different parts of the game. Like you saw him, like he came in with just bounce in defense.
Facts.
Then he was like this ugly ass corner three that he was making. I don't know how it was going in.
Yeah,
but it started falling.
Yeah,
and then he just became like this veteran presence that was just good. Like he was just really good.
Yeah.
Physically sound.
He was so perfect for any team. He was like one of those guys like you just put on any team and he'll be perfect for your little three position, whatever you needed.
Hey, he was a part of one of my most, other than the Utah Jazz with Stockton and Malone, I hated that Suns team because they always beat Kobe and Odom and that Lakers team. So he was a part of that team. He'd give us problems because he'd kill us on the boards. He'd come guard Kobe a little bit. He'd make some threes, run the floor, dunk. So, man, Sean Marion, shout out to him.
Wait, shout out a memory about Sean Marion. You could not stop Jordan from hitting that game. All-Star game.
It wasn't going to happen.
He tried.
He had a lot of embarrassing moments, but hey, his numbers, he got some solid numbers. 15-8, 1-1, 1 steal, 1 block.
That's career
respectable.
Averages?
Career average.
That's respectable, huge, bro. Yeah. That's very respectable.
Because his last few years,
did he get a game ring with Dallas?
Yeah, Dallas. So. Yeah, he won a ring with Dallas.
He might make the Hall of Fame on like his fifth time.
Yeah, he should. He probably is going to make it. Man, four-time All-Star. He was a part of one of that great Phoenix team during that time. We talked about him earlier. They weren't able to win one, but they were a 60-win team multiple years. So, man, Sean Marion is our Throwback Thursday Player of the Week. For you guys who don't know who he is, make sure you go and look him up. Go look up some highlights. Remember, check our Courtside Radio Instagram. We're going to have some highlights up of him. Man, we thank you guys for listening to us. What a perfect way to go out to this Dr. Dre classic. My boy Bruce is a monster on the boards,
the
man.
The maestro.
Of
the ones and twos.
Of the ones and twos. But, man, we thank you guys for tuning in to Courtside Radio, the realest, the illest, the dopest hoop show in the land with these starting five. Hey, we are grinding. Be ready. June, I'm letting y'all know right now, we're going to be live. Every Thursday, we're going to be live somewhere.
We coming,
baby. Are we announcing next week or not?
Come out and show us some love.
Should we?
Yes, so let's next week we will be live as well. May 16th, we will be there at the Truth Hollywood, Paul Hookah Pierce's Lounge. Hookah Lounge.
We know all you love IG thoughts.
Make sure you guys come out, show love, show support. You can do the hookah. You can get you a dope beverage.
They got a full bar.
Full bar. They got cigar food, game. Man.
Roscoe's is right downstairs. Hey,
say
for
that
the
again.
After party.
This is.
Paul Pierce is most likely going to be there. I know it's playoff time to ESPN, but you just have a lot of NBA, like former NBA guys out, different celebrities. I can't remember the dude's name, but last time I was there, the guy from the show Power, the light-skinned dude with the Jackie Potter.
Amari Hardwick.
Oh, no, the other one.
The other guy.
Oh, I was about to say, because he's banned.
He was there. Oh, he's banned from your wife? He's probably that guy.
Idris?
No.
Nah. Yeah, the guy with the accent. Yeah, he has an accent. I can't remember his name.
He's low-key funny, too.
I saw him on the Shade Room. I'm like, oh, that's old boy. But, you know, I don't really watch Power like that, so I couldn't tell
you
exactly.
He was on Power?
Yeah, he plays in Power. Yes, like
he's really not like Amari? He's African, I believe. It is.
Nah, like the light not skin. Amari. Hey, but hey, I'm just letting you guys know it's you might celebrities just show up there just to hang out and chill.
True.
Come out and chill. Come and show some support. Show some love. It's gonna be the first of our two live shows set up in the next 2 months at the Truth. We're gonna be there next week, the 16th. Then also June 20th, which is going to be a part of our run of live shows. So, hey, Courtside Radio, man, we doing big things. Good news.
Huge.
Sports
through, baby.
Doing big things. Up next, Touchdown with Tangents. Make sure you guys checking out Sports Talk with Mark on every Saturday. Hey.
And Ladies Night on Friday, baby. Hey.
Get on board with the Good News Sports right now.
Oh, man.
Because when we popping.
Yeah, don't be.
Don't try
don't
to ride
be
the
trying
wave.
To come. Nah, ain't none of that.
Ain't no wave surfer. You too late.
Nah,
we only,
too
we
late.
Only taking thoroughbreds, baby.
Hey, so Jackie in the building out. Once again. Ladies' night.
Yes.
Every Friday.
Every Friday.
Turn the mic on.
Oh, no, do that again. Do that again. Oh.
Every Friday at 7:30. Check us out, Ladies' Night.
Ladies'
every
night.
Every Friday is Ladies' Night.
They talk
yes, sir.
Crazy on
News Radio,
crazy.
Baby.
All they do is bash guys.
They oh, might
not. Wait a minute.
I'm just kidding.
That
it was a joke.
We love y'all, ladies. We love y'all, ladies.
She always says it's a non-lady, a non-male bashing show.
Yeah.
It's and like then she goes straight to bashing males like 5 seconds later.
Yeah.
But it's you like know, it's cool.
After the intro, she let it know. So you can say, I keep hearing it, then it's a wrap. She
yeah,
men
she
alive.
Just roast us the whole show. But it's cool, you know.
And just know if you ever run into Mahdi anywhere and you're a guy, make sure you guys protect your cups because
leave
she on that,
my co-host alone.
She on that
just...
Cardi B.
Damn. So,
hey, make sure that she listens to this because she got to know that I have
we
to
know.
Let everybody know to protect, you know, protect my cups out here.
She Pill Cosby.
Well, nobody should leave their cup unattended anywhere, men or women.
Facts,
especially
with Mahdi around. So
Pill Cosby herself.
Hey,
Pill Cosby.
Courtside Radio starting 5. Mike Kell the PG here. Check me out on IG. Mike, drop the IG.
You already know. Come through, Mister. I'm a Mister _. I'm gonna call you back. Out of Pappy in the building.
Yes, sir.
We're here, baby.
What's up, Bruce? Let drop the IG, Mister.
You know
Shice
what
right.
it is. I'm gonna turn the music off. Shice right. On the IG.
Yes, sir.
You can always find me. I'm always on there roasting everybody. Don't come with no BS. I got hot takes for everybody. But follow us for sure. Courtside Radio. Good News Radio.
Good News Sports.
Good News Sports. We doing big things, y'all.
Hey, big things. So thank you guys for tuning in. Touchdown and Tangents are up next. We are out. Peace.
Deuces.
We out. Gone.